ChiIL Mama is here today with Jeff, the author and illustrator of the Wimpy Kid series, and also Pop Tropica, I understand.
That's right. That's my day job.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Now, I understand you're not only a writer and illustrator, but also a dad. You have two?
That's right. I have a 7-year-old and a 10-year-old, and freshly minted 10-year-old, and I miss them right about now. You know, it's tough to be away from them for so long, but I'll get to see them in a few days.
Excellent. Now, you're hitting up 50 bookstores in 1 week?
That's right. We are being very ambitious.
Great.
I'm just sun in stock here on the bus.
Nice. Get a little jump on the writer's cramp there.
We try to get ahead of the game so that if we ever get in trouble on the schedule, we can do a swap of signed stock, unsigned stock.
I'm getting signed first. Okay. Yeah.
Excellent. Now, we've been doing a long-running video series on how creatives parent and how parents create. Like, how do the worlds collide? Did your worldview or your writing and illustrating change once you became a parent?
I don't think they did, actually. It hasn't had much of an effect. I have a little bit less time. But I think in a way, having children is a new input. It's a new, it's kind of a new form of energy and creativity. So it's added to my writing, I think.
Now, are your boys wimpy kids? I mean, did some of that material from real life make it into the books? Or?
No, my boys aren't wimpy kids, no. I think my, one of my sons thought he was an indoor person, but then did an about face and became kind of a sporty kid.
Ah. Yeah, I was kind of the yearbook editor, newspaper, theater dork, and my kids are gymnasts and drummers and rock musicians. So they're 7 and 9.
That's funny.
I mean, 7 and 9, my goodness. They're 9 and 11. They're going to throttle me. I lost a couple years there.
That's cool.
Yeah, it's right.
This is a really cool town. I've never been here before. And what we're trying to do is we're traveling around in a giant bus, right? A giant Wimpy Kid bus. Maybe we could even get the kids' pictures in front of it at the end.
That'd be awesome.
That work, Jason? That might be. We'll try to make that work.
Uh-oh, we lost your Greg Heffley there. Popping you in the head.
He's in there.
That's true. Maybe his hair is going to fall out.
Yeah, so one hair for every third of the tour is coming off of the character.
We're right in the middle of our tour. And in fact, we have a Greg Heffley in the bus, right? And he has 3 hairs. And one of the hairs just got knocked off because that means we're a third of the way through with our tour. But where are we going tomorrow? Michigan?
No, we're going to Ohio tomorrow. We'll be in Minneapolis tonight and then Cincinnati.
And then Michigan. And then we go to Toronto and then New York. So this is we're right in the middle of our tour. And I think I have time for a little doodle, right? Yep, so I can look at a little drawing in the book too. So why don't we get started, okay? You like that part? There you go, thanks. A lot of small, like 100-person book signs, which is actually big, and I'm grateful that that many people show up. But then at night we have 1,200-person.
Yeah, the big bash rockin' party.
Yeah.
Nice.
So it's a nice way to have intimate meet and greets with, you know, more impersonal, bigger events.
Absolutely. So who's think you're going to go out to it, or? Yeah. So, big dance party with over 1,000 people, huh? Are you guys excited? But this is pretty cool, too. You get to get your book signed and have a little smaller.
That's small.
Yeah. Do you have a favorite book?
Like the first.
Yeah? Have you guys read them all? Have you read them all? Yeah? Absolutely. So whose brainstorm was that, the 50 book thing? Did you come up with that?
I'm going to take credit for that.
You should.
But Jason came up with the idea of DJing the events, which was, I thought, great.
And the dance floor, yeah.
It was a combination of our forces.
Oh, very fun. So that has to be some kind of Guinness Book of World Records setting book tour there.
You know, it's great to break it up like that because in the past we've done just one really big event a day, and the events got so big that we ended up with 3.5 and 4 hour book signings.
That's
really
brutal.
Too hard on everyone.
Yeah. So how do you combat the writer's cramp?
Luckily, I have a big loopy signature, so it doesn't seem to affect me at all. It's
nice.
Great.
Now writing and illustrating is a rather solitary pursuit a lot of the time, and this big crazy boat tour is anything but.
That's
which
the truth.
Elements really mesh with your personality, or do you love all of it?
I like all of it. It is hard for me actually to be social as much as the book tour requires.
Yeah,
it's really hard to kind of wake up and be on.
Yeah, that's a lot of people time.
Yeah, but that's one of the reasons that we got the bus, was so that we could kind of decompress between stops. And I'm traveling with my assistant and Jason Wells, the publicity director, and I think we're very respectful of each other's times when we just need quiet.
Yes.
Yeah, I think that that's good.
Well, we will wrap it up and let you get to your book signing, but it was a pleasure to meet you.
Likewise. Thank you for your interest. I appreciate it so much.
Oh, absolutely. It was great, and we thank you so much for taking the time to meet with us today.
Take care.
We have 27. We could have rented, like...
something like that, yeah.
Yeah, a huge auditorium.
This is...
Have you guys read the other Wimpy Kids books?
Yeah.
Yeah?
I've read all of them. I've read all of them.
Okay, show me your hands. Who's read all of them? Wow. Most of you guys. Who has a favorite part?
I like the dog things.
Yeah?
My favorite part is where
there's a what?
The water park.
Oh, water park. Who likes the cheese touch?
Oh.
You guys like that silly part? Yeah? You guys like the cheese touch part?
Yeah. I haven't read any of them. I'm done with the first one. I'm going to go try and get other ones.
Nice. Have you read all of them?
I only read this one. So I read half of this, so I like this one.
Very cool. Are you guys excited to meet Jeff today?
Yes.
That's pretty cool and special.
Yeah.
You guys have an awesome school that you got to get out of school and come over here.
Yeah.
It's probably as much fun for the adults as it is for the
Seriously?
Kids, huh? I take my own kids. I have a 9 and 11 year old, and I take them to a lot of book signings, and I think I'm more of a geek about them than they are. You know? They're like, yeah, yeah, whatever.
Hi.
I do. I have a 7-year-old and a 10-year-old. And how old are you?
I'm
32.
And
how
did you decide to make a movie?
I thought it'd be fun. Yeah. Yeah, I know those kids well. They're good friends of mine, actually. Both Rowley and Greg. Yeah, they're good guys. In fact, we usually go on book tours with them.
So then this might clear the way a little.